Hi, and welcome to chapter number 8, NGINX Unit as a web server. In this lecture, we will dive into Unit's web server use cases and how to configure NGINX Unit to be a web server. So without even more saying, let's jump directly in. So I'm here on my Ubuntu 22.04 box, and we have a plain Unit installation. And to check this, we already know we can do curl localhost. It is listening on port 9000. So we can do the config check. We have no listeners, no routes, no applications. Pretty simple configuration. Okay, so I'm already in the chapters folder, which has the wrong number. So let's move that to chapter number 8, just to make sure I'm not confused by my own typing. So we do not have anything in here. So let's do mkdir dub 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 to create an dub 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 web root directory. And in dub dub dub, we can create an index.html file. So let's open this one up in VS Code. All right, that was already up. Let me close that one real quick. Do that again. Great, so that opens up. Thanks VS Code for starting. Perfect, so I would like in dub dub dub, I would like to create a new file that is called index.html. New file, index, not imp next, in index.html. Good. So now let's create a simple HTML file, typing HTML. Let's close up HTML here. Then we do at least some basic HTML stuff. We have a title defined that is called welcome from NGINX unit. Head here. That is wrong, that is right. Under the head, we put a body, and in the body, we put in, let's put in this one in and tell the user, welcome to the NGINX unit course. Right, hitting Control S on my keyboard to save that, and now we need an unit configuration file. So let's hit the plus icon once more. That one is called unit.conf.json. Let's move this up into the root of that directory. Is that even working? Why is that not working? Okay, I give up. No worries, we'll move that later. So we start off with a blank unit configuration. Again, we already know we need listeners, blank. We need routes, which is an object or an array of route objects. Last but not least, we need applications, or we can define applications. They are not needed in this tutorial, but I like to have a plain unit configuration to get started with. So the listener is something we already know. We can define asterisk port 80 to listen on port 80. And then we have a listener object, and the listener object needs a pass argument to tell unit what to do with an incoming request. And we simply send it over to the routes. Like, all right, I'm good here. I'm the listener. The processing will be handled by the NGINX unit router. All right, in here, in this array, we can have a list of route objects, routing objects. And a route object contains out of two things. We will learn more advanced things in the lecture about the request router. This simple tutorial, we just need an action. So in the route object, we have an action object, and inside of the action object, we can define something that is called share. And share can be a simple string, or it can be an array of strings. So let's start with a simple thing here and specify something that is called SRV $URI, for example. So that would mean that we need to move the index.html file to server /URI. So let's see if this is a thing. So let's ls the root, and we have SRV in here. We already have ... in here. We do not. This is owned by root, right? So let's do sudo mkdir ... Also fine. So now let's go back to our chapter number 8, move ... index to, and now you will see what the issue will be to that. Permission denied. Okay, be sudo. Keep this in mind. Just make a note of this permission denied. We will see that this will maybe come to some issues later. All right, so now going back to SRV ... there is an index.html file in server ... index.html. Perfect. So we want to share server ... and anything that is the URI of the request. Index.html will be default, but for example, image.jpg, style.css will be part of the URI, and unit will take care of this one with this $URI. So that looks good. Okay, we have moved it, not copied it. That's why the VS Code is a little bit crying. Not a problem at all. I'm using the tilde to jump back to my home directory, cd into chapter number 8. And where is my unit configuration? It was in ... I believe that it was because we were not able to move that somewhere else. It is here. So let's do a brief check with JQ if this is syntactically correct. JSON, it is. So now we already know our nice trick to use cat to define unitconf.json and send it over to the standard input of the data and over to config. So it's saying reconfiguration done. So potentially when we do something like curl, control R on my keyboard to search the bash history, and then we curl localhost port 9000 /config that prints the current unit config. So potentially when we curl localhost, we should be able to see our welcome.html. That is the case. So what happened? So let's go back to server. Go back to ... and index.html. As we can see at the permission level of this server ... and with the configuration of this box, unit is able to query the data inside of this directory. So the most important thing to understand and to know is that if we want to use NGINX Unit as a web server, the web server is owned by the router user. And to check the router user, we can use pself to grep for unit, and the router is on unit. So server ... is a good place to store the files, as the permissions will already be set in a way that unit can access it. If we have this, for example, in our home directory, we have to make sure that the index.html file and all other resources are probably be accessible by the unit user, that is the run user for the router process. In this special case, in server ... it works, and we can curl our index.html file. And in case we define anything that is not present, we see the error 404. All right, so in this lecture, we have learned the basics about NGINX Unit as a web server. And in the next lecture, we will add another little add-on to this one and configure and custom 404 page for our web server. So if you're curious, stay tuned and check out the next chapter about Unit as a web server. See you there.